folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and it's my favourite time of the year. It's spooky season. So in today's video, I'm teaching you 8 spooky sounds you can make with your guitar this Halloween. Now off the bat, I am going to say I'm not going to be teaching you spooky riffs, because there's so many awesome spooky riffs from Sabbath, Zeppelin, Mayhem, so many awesome... and like... So many awesome riffs like that, so feel free to comment down below your favourite spooky riff. But in this video, we'll be doing crazy spooky sounds to scare your neighbours, or your kids, or your parents, or if you're at a gig and playing this Halloween, you can play it in the middle of the set and blow everyone's ghostly minds. For this rig, I'm using lots of delay and reverb because it makes everything sound that little bit spookier. The delay, I'm using the delay built into the Blackstar St. James 6L6 head. I'm hearing through the cab, but you guys are hearing it through the XLR cab rig output of the back of it. And for delay, I'm using the Black Country Customs Difference Engine, which is a beautiful delay. Some of these sounds will involve a Floyd Rose tremolo system. So for that, I'll be using my Kramer Pacer. And for the rest of the stuff, I'll be using this Lizzie Hale Explorer Bird by Gibson, because look at it, it's as spooky as a really spooky thing. So let's get into it with the first spooky sound. Now the first sound doesn't necessarily involve a guitar with a tremolo, but you do need a piece of metal, ideally, and tremolo bars are a great shout for this. So make sure your bridge pickup is engaged and get funky ass sounds like this. That's a dying clown right there if I ever heard one. So this sound was, the first time I ever saw anyone do it was Herman Lee from Dragon Force, because it's like a Pac-Man sound. When you do it fast, it does sound like Pac-Man. When you do it slowly, with reverb and delay, it sounds awfully spooky. So all you do is get your piece of metal, make sure the bridge pickup is engaged, and rub it up and down the strings. How funky is that? And if you haven't got a piece of metal handy, rock a guitar pick. Where's all my picks gone? Get a guitar pick. And everyone knows a pick scrape, like... instead of going down towards the neck, go over the strings. Same, make sure the bridge pickup is engaged. Sound is good when it's not metal, but the side of a pick, the edge of a pick, works just awesome. The next sound does involve a tremolo arm, and it's this. What was that? What the hell's going on there? So this is a funky little sound I got from watching Joe Satriani. I think he calls it down the throat of the lizard or something. And basically, I'm using the G string. Use any string if you want. It's really hard to do, actually. Go up the up the neck, like slide up the neck, but also move the tremolo arm down. So what you're trying to do, right? So that naturally goes up in pitch when you slide up the neck, and when you drop the bar of a tremolo, the pitch naturally goes down. So what the aim is to keep that original note. So you're countering the pitch going up while sliding up with the tremolo arm going down. It's quite a jarring little sound, isn't it? How awesome and off-putting is that? In at number 3 for spooky sounds, we simply have play parts of the guitar which weren't originally intended to be played. So in the case of a guitar with a trem, the good old springs at the back give them a little play with the pick. And when you have again, reverb and delay on, sounds terrifying. So all you've got to do is literally just pick scrape the springs at the back. Or almost sounds like a bell chiming, doesn't it? It's awesome. Eddie Van Halen used to do this a lot too during his solos. There's even more fun to be had on guitars without locking tremolos and whatnot, because you can get behind the nut. And behind the bridge as well. Bloody awesome. It's a lot more fun as well if you have a guitar like a semi-hollow or something with the Bigsby, when you've got a lot of string hangage between the bridge and the tailpiece. That kind of thing. It's funky and it's spooky and hopefully it'll scare everyone. Next up, do you know beforehand I mentioned pick scrapes when it was the those noises? Everyone knows a pick scrape going down the neck. But when you pick scrape going the other way and you go slowly and you really dig in, spooky as hell. So start up by the nut of the guitar and really kind of dig in. There's a fine line between actually trying to play hard and not get the frets hit, so you're not actually going up as the notes, as you kind of heard there. There's a special kind of subtlety thing you need to have while also trying to sound terrifying. So it is just straight up kind of. No one ever picks scrapes down here. People are so used to the pick scrapes happening down there that when you do them down the way, it gives you a lovely kind of guttural, low, like almost bell-like tone, like big bell being hit in Notre Dame or Big Ben in London. Bloody terrifying, and it's awesome. Next up, staying with the tremless guitar in the form of this Explorer Bird, we have behind the nut bends, which, well, if you haven't got a tremolo, it's how you get a pitch effect like the start of Iron Man by Black Sabbath, Tony doing it, or Dazed and Confused by Zeppelin. Very ominous, it's quite a profound kind of sound. It stands very proud, it's very bold. Yeah, I'm just gonna do it on the low E string as well. You can kind of, it's not the best headstock to do it with, but the pinch harmonics and that kind of stuff. Natural harmonics. And again, it's super easy to do. Just bend behind the nut of the guitar. Easy as that, and it's spooky. Next up, we have making your guitar scream. Not scream like, but scream like a damsel in distress. It's essentially just a pick, I'm gonna go a bit deeper on it because it is one of Eddie Van Halen's famous sounds. When you use it without a tremolo, have a bit of fun with the volume control and make it kind of die out. So it's a pinch harmonic on the fourth fret of the G string. Give it a bend and then kind of let it fall. I suppose you can kind of do it anywhere if you. Four on the G string is my personal favorite. If you don't actually know how to do a pinch harmonic, like Zakk Wylde or Billy Gibbons, the best way I could teach you is find a note that you want to get a pinch from, let's say the ninth fret of the A string, and just play as hard as you can. You will naturally hear there's some pinch harmonic kind of frequencies wanting to jump through along with all the mess of trying to play hard. It's down to you to pick a bit lighter, because the nature of pinch harmonic is that the pad of your thumb hits against the string once the pick's hit it. So it's your job to find the balance between hitting hard and playing it at a regular kind of thrash to get the pitch harmonic to shine through. It also helps if to try and make the note pull out, because you want to make those note, those harmonic frequencies pull out. Rotate your wrist and try and find the sweet spot with your thumb and your pick. Worth noting as well, pinch harmonics sound different depending on where you pick between the pickups or the pickup and the neck, depending on how many pickups your guitar's got. So this sounds different to this. But if you really want to elevate this spooky sound to the next level, get a guitar with a double locking tremolo system on. You can do it with a regular Strat trem, but your guitar might go out of tune. Floyd Rose systems and Ibanez Edges are designed to get lots of abuse but stay perfectly in tune. Now when it comes to using the Floyd with the pinch harmonic, let it drop slowly, because this sound was made famous by my personal lord and savior, Mr. Edward Van Halen, and it was coined as the horse noise. And when you use it fast, Eddie used to do this all the time, like flutter it, it sounds like a horse whinnying. We don't want that, we don't want to sound like a horse, we want to sound like someone screaming. That's what we want, and it sounds spooky, and it sounds like they're getting dragged away through the dirt screaming. And that's how to make your guitar scream. Now these last two sounds are going to feature a tremolo system quite heavily. Well, you need a tremolo system to get these tones, and like I said, I'd ideally like you to use a double locking tremolo, just because they take a lot of abuse. The first one is just a straight up dive bomb. No matter how many times you hear them, they just keep sounding more awesome and awesome. Now whether when your guitar to sound like a cyborg or an air raid siren or Dimebag Darrell, it's one of the coolest things you can do with the guitar when it has a Floyd Rose system, but not a lot of people know how to do them well. So I'm going to show you. I can openly say, honestly, I dive bomb at least 5 times a day. Even when I haven't got a gig or even when I don't have a guitar in my hands, I just naturally dive bomb. I love doing them so bloody much. And the nature of a dive bomb is just pretty much you have to hit a natural harmonic on the fret of a guitar. Do you know, we see some people hitting the harmonics on the 12th fret. It's just kind of resting your finger over the actual metal of the fret instead of the fretted note. Don't actually play the note on the fret, just rest it gently. Yeah, some people tune up like that. That kind of thing you're looking for, but you can play it kind of anywhere. There's a lot of them around the fingerboard. My personal favorites are on the G and the B string of the 5, 7, 9, 3, and sometimes 2. The second fret ones are really hard to get, but yeah, a few ways you can do them. Pick them and then drop the bar. You can do it the Dimebag Darrell way, which is drop the bar. This works better when it's a floating bar, so you can pull up a little bit as well, so your trem doesn't just go down in pitch. It also goes up in pitch ever slightly as well. And that is drop the bar, spin it around, slacken the strings right off. Then kind of flick it, in this case the G string, and then tap the third fret of the G. Or wherever you want to go. That elusive second fret one's ridiculous. And again, you haven't, the third way, you haven't got to drop the bar to flick it and catch the nose. Whatever's more comfortable, whatever technique in which you're doing a dive bomb. Either one of those three ways will be perfect for you, and that is the ultimate guide to doing a dive bomb. Now last but certainly not least, but I am going to include some honourable mentions at the end, we have Eddie Van Halen's famous elephant noise as well, but it can be used in a number of different applications, and it hasn't got to be an elephant. It's this. So that is just straight up an elephant, but when you take it out of context, It doesn't sound like an elephant, it sounds awesome and terribly spooky, which is the point of this video. Here's how you do it. So it actually starts with the volume down on your guitar. You hit a 5th fret harmonic on the G string, 7th fret harmonic on the B string, which actually sounds pretty dissonant anyways. Then top it all off with a 12th fret harmonic on the high E string. But do all that with the volume off, okay? Then you want to reach around with your left hand, drop the tremolo on, and while you're putting the pitch up on the tremolo, turn the volume up on your guitar and then back down again. Does sound a bit like whales as well, which isn't a bad thing, but yeah. That's how to do the famous EVH elephant sound. Now, a couple of honourable mentions to mention at the end. Speaking of natural harmonics, those things that we've been doing for the dive bombs and the EVH whales sound there, if you bring your left hand over the top of the fingerboard and you play natural harmonics on the low E string, you can actually take them all the way to the bridge pickup, and it's pretty cool sounding. It's not the spookiest thing in the world, but it will turn heads. And finally, you don't need a pick or anything for this, but you do need, say, something like a mobile phone. And when you turn the volume up on your guitar and you play music into the bridge pickup, it will come through your amplifier. People don't really realize that these are actually microphones. So that, ladies and gentlemen, is some spooky sounds you can play with your electric guitar. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you want anything or explain anything, please feel free to and share the love. And like I said at the start, if you want to include your favorite spooky riff from Zeppelin, Sabbath, anything in between, please feel free to as well. I might do that on a follow-up video in the future, but let me know. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the gear I've used in this video, the Kramer, the Lizzie Hill Explorer Bird, the Amplifier, the Black Country Customs Difference Engine Delay Pedal, everything's linked in the description box down below. We are playing music today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of all these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.